Attention! This video is made by high qualified idiots and we spend our lives to become them, so don't try to make it at home, just enjoy the video.
Working half a year on high pressure electrolyzer, 99 days of self-isolation underground work, a month on jewelry job of building and upgrading lightsaber.
So now, when the quarantine is almost finished and I can even go outside without breaking the law?
My brain asked me about 2 days rest, so I decided to build something simple, something powerful, mad and fun, something for outside rampage with my friends.
So stop playing around, my mate from YouTube space wanted to crash some stuff with a bowling ball and they asked me how it can be done. So in this video I'll show you how I made powerful bowling ball launcher. Let's do some math.
If we want beautiful frames of destroying some stuff like an old TV set with a bowling ball or thick plywood with a watermelon, we need to accelerate bowling ball to at least 60 miles per hour. First, I wanted to build a big hydrogen cannon, but you know, it's too noisy and quite illegal. Big crossbow with metal springs from the Lord of the Rings is too expensive. Rail launcher is impossible because if the ball start to roll and spin, it just split away. So the best choice is a metal frame catapult with rubber tapes. What about size and parameters? Two rules of thumb. The bigger the shell weight, the longer is acceleration distance. Also, the rubber tension must be enough for full load. Run through detailed calculations that you skip anyway. We need 20 feet of acceleration distance and 1000 pounds of thrust to accelerate 13-pound bowling ball to 60 miles per hour. I bet you know physics better if I was your teacher, don't you? The goal is clear, the sun is shining again, so what do we need for this rampage? Square metal pipes for catapult body, some screws, nuts and rubber tapes that you can find anywhere because gyms are opened again and home sport equipment are lying in every garbage can, couple of bowling balls, a manual winch, a good music and a good friend of mine. I'm taking a dip now. Don't need no air, I'm feeding the worms. Don't call me lazy, I'm pushing up daisies. I'm at the river, now I'm one big sleeper. I don't give a crap, I'm taking a dip now. I got my toes up. Leave me alone, I'm nothing but bone. You know, after building hydrogen booster and lightsaber, making a simple metal frame is just a rest. And the most complex thing is a trigger that must stand 1000 pounds of load and release all the load instantly with only one single move. So we show special thanks and respect to Mr. Sprave for helping us with technical drawings of this device. Thank you for your help and thank you for your awesome slingshot channel. After building a frame, we fixed a manual winch and rubbers, make a stud table, a basket for a ball and adjustable stands. After manufacturing all the parts, we join it together and start some test preparing. One more time. Don't even try to make it yourself. Total energy of 1000 pounds of tension load with 13-pound ball is 1.5 kilojoules. This energy is enough to accelerate watermelon from 0 to 60 miles per hour 25 times faster than Tesla Model S does it. Also, this energy is enough to shift International Space Station to another orbit. So if something go wrong with the trigger, you wouldn't forget it till the end of days. But if you're just watching the video, stay calm, because we are real professionals, so the best thing we figure out is to hide behind the thin plywood.
Тебе страшно?
А, ехали!
Ну все, теперь если что-то пойдет не так, оно хоть в эфир попадет. Ладно, давай! На один шок секунду я сказал. Стой! 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 Резина цепляется, резина цепляется! Подожди! Дурак!
Whoa, you cannot continue watching this awesome test shooting by the simple cell phone, so click here and enjoy real slow-mo cameras and multi-copters views, and enjoy our new What a Mess channel.